The Friday, I was sitting home and I was talking to a friend on the phone because I had just finished doing the ironing when the door knocked. But the way the door knocked, I thought was my son coming in because it was, I think it was minutes to, I wasn't too sure about the time to be precise. But when the door knocked, I said it was my son. And I said to him, Noon, why don't you come with your key? But I went in the window and I looked and I saw yes. the flashing blue light. And that's when I said, I hope Noon is not in trouble again. Mm-hmm. And then I walked downstairs. But when I walked downstairs, the man said, two people, they walked in. And they said, are you Jessica Plummer? Are you Shaquan Sammy Plummer's mom? And I said, yes. And they started telling me. But from the time the lady told me, it's like I felt weak. Mm-hmm. I couldn't walk up the steps. I fell on the stairs and the lady helped me up. But I didn't get no phone call. They came and they told me and the flashing blue light. So what I did, they rushed me and then I had to run upstairs, get myself together and then for me to leave with them. But they begged my son, but my mind did not tell me at the time that something happened. It never tell me that. Because you're not thinking of the worst.
No. That's like when I was in the police, that police van, I would just keep thinking, is he all right? Is he all right? Because no one was telling me nothing. All they kept saying is they're working on him. And they wouldn't tell me anything else.
They didn't even tell me that they're working on him. All they said to me is he's in hospital. They just called him and they told him and it happened in Enfield. So they called Islington police and the police came and picked me up. But the woman, that's what I kept on saying, the lady no, but she didn't want to tell me. So when we got to the hospital, they told me, say, why didn't you tell me? So the first thing was, can I see my son? The man who operated on him, he said yes. But at the time, because I was so scared, I said no.
And we couldn't even see Charlie. They wouldn't even let us near him.
No, they didn't. After a while, the police officer said, no, they did not want us to see him because I think by you touching, you could mess up
the evidence.
But then it left me broken for days. I wasn't able to eat. I couldn't eat because I was just there like, it's like you in a dream, you're dreaming, but that
and
dream.
And you think that dream's never happened, it's not happening.
Exactly, because I'm still living in that dream. Exactly.
Even today, it's like it was yesterday.
Yes.
Even though it's nearly 2 years, Charlie's been gone now, it's still hard. Every day I get up, I see his little brother who's near enough, he looks like Charlie, and he's got a little girl, and she looks like him as well. Over and over every day.
You see, I don't have nothing. All I have is just the pictures, photos of him in my bedroom window, and I cannot. The photos is too much for me. Sometimes for me to look at the photos, it's like, what happened to him? Where is he? When is he coming back? Like the New Year's. For the New Year's, for me, it was one of the most difficult ones because I'm waiting for the front door to open. Because normally he goes out New Year's Day, him and the sister, and he will come in like about 8 o'clock in the morning. So I'm waiting for the front door to open for him to walk in, but it never happened. I sit in the little garden in the front and ask myself question as to why.
Why, yeah.
And what I can do to get him back. I've asked myself the question several times. What do I do to get my son back? Because he was like the father in the house. He fixed every single thing in my house. His name is on everything in my house. When you go into the computer, his name is on there. In my phone, his name is still on there.
Same as with me, Charlie's still on my phone.
You see, and I cannot remove it.
Because I got the call. He went out at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. It was a Monday afternoon. It was pouring down the rain. And he said, Mum, I'm going now. See you later. And that was the last.
That's exactly
the last I saw of him. And then an hour later, I got the phone call to say that Charlie had been stabbed.